welcome to church.
A big, big welcome right from our living room, or at least the room that used to be our living room, which is nowadays more or less the kita of our son, Aaron. But honestly, it was so great to see so many of you on Zoom just now. And I think it's the best way to start a Sunday all together.
Yeah.
Hey, and we would love to see even more of you next Sunday. So feel dearly invited to just join on Zoom before we go into the service all together. And if you want to do so, you find the link in the description below.
Awesome. Yeah, I love it. It's so awesome to swipe and to swipe and to swipe and to see so many faces. And yeah. Hey, girls, I just wanted to invite you and just remind you that Color Conference is coming up this coming Friday. And let me just tell you, it's amazing. I'm so excited. When I first got to know Color 8 years or something ago, it wasn't really appealing to me. But then I actually got to know him. I actually made the decision to come. And since then, I've grown so much and it has helped me in so many ways. So yeah, if you have registered already, great. And if not, you can also find that link in the description below.
Yeah, so cool. And hey, another cool thing that's happening this month for everybody is Enlarge Learning on Tuesday nights. So this month, it will all be about God, money, and me. And will be the best nights coming together online on the next 3 Tuesdays and learning all together about biblical finances. And actually, we can tell you, all we know about finance and budgeting, we basically know from church. So we definitely can tell you, you don't want to miss this out. So if you want to register, you can do so in the link below. And I promise you, it will change your perspective of finances.
Awesome. Yeah. Now, church, let's lean in together. Mm-hmm. Let's give him all the praise and let's be expectant for this great day.
Staring into your eyes makes my heart come alive. Suddenly brought to life when I met you. Reaching me.
Go before you and behind you and beside you, all around you, and within you, he's
Hi, church. How good is to praise and worship together? I don't know about you, but at home I have to stand up, dance, sing, and I love this moment because it's all about bringing our eyes back to Jesus and His faithfulness, thanking God for who He is, regardless of the external circumstances. So in a moment, we are gonna pray for people's needs, for your needs and your family and friends, believing God for His promises over our lives. So wherever you are today, why don't you join me in prayer and lift up His name over every situation. So we are believing for salvation for family and friends. We are believing for healing from our brother that had cancer, a renewed hope for the future, freedom from depression, comfort, financial provision, exams to go well, and also the vaccine to be available worldwide in Jesus' name. So Lord, we just pray for every need represented here. We thank You that we can place our hope in You. We know that You are faithful and that care for each of us. So we pray for health, hope, and wholeness in Jesus' name. Amen. So as always, I would love to share our good reports with you. This is amazing to see what God is doing in people's lives. So we're celebrating salvations. Last week, we had people making decisions to follow Jesus. Best decision. So that's amazing. People thanking God for a church family over this tough time, a fast recovery after an operation, promotion at work, and someone started a new business. I think this is Ina. Congratulations. That's great. Also someone thanking God for past exams. And we have a newborn baby. Baby Ivy is in the family. So I love it. That's great. New member of the family. That's beautiful. So now I would like to take this opportunity to encourage all of us with a giving. And we've been reading this Bible verse in Jeremiah 17, Anders and me, and it has really helped us. So I'm sure it's going to help you personally. But blessed are those who trust the Lord and have made Him their hope and confidence. You know, when we bring our tithes and offerings to the house, it's an opportunity to teach our hearts how to trust God. What we have experienced in our lives is that it brings honor to God, has strengthened our faith, and is also taking our church forward. So that's so exciting to see. So let's pray together. Thank You, God, for everyone that is faithful, Father. We pray for Your blessing over them as they trust and put their hope in You. In Jesus' name, amen. So feel free and be encouraged to use our giving app, online giving, PayPal, whatever works best for you. Awesome. So let's get ready for the Word. Today we have our very own Pastor Mark with us, so lean in and be encouraged.
Hey everyone, good to see you, and thank God you've been able to join us today. Online services, we're going to continue, and we're going to continue doing this because we really want to take this moment to keep pouring into your life, so I appreciate you being here. And you know, God wants to continue to speak into our hearts, helps to strengthen us, helps us to all keep our head clear as we move forward. So today's message is called, Do Words Matter? Do Words Matter? And you know, we're living in a very interesting time, and there's so much tension and there's so much toxicity going on, and there's a whole lot of words and a whole lot of opinions. And I don't know, world seems to be polarized in so many different ways. So I think today what we're gonna do is, or what I'd love to do is take a moment just to really look at God's Word and really pull from God's Word when it comes to our lives in the area of words. So the question or the message title today is called, Do Words Matter? You know, I think words do matter. Most of you would agree that words are actually really crucial to our health and our well-being. But you know, when we look at God's Word, maybe we forget sometimes how much wisdom is found in God's Word when it comes to this whole perspective. So today, I'm just gonna pull a few thoughts out from God's Word, different aspects that really helps us to appreciate and to understand really the wisdom of the power of words. So maybe today I can start off with some questions. Whose words actually do you listen to? Whose words matter most to you? Whose words do you actually live by? You know, when it comes to words that are spoken over our lives, there are words that are helpful and there are words that are not helpful. You know, the words of Jesus, I really believe, can be helpful to all of us. I believe the words of Jesus are helpful to all of humanity because no one spoke like Jesus. The way He said it And Jesus said things that no one ever said. Like, for example, Jesus said, I am the way, the truth, and the life. You know, these are pretty strong statements that Jesus made. He said lots of things through the Gospel of John. We see seven statements that he made about himself. I am the door, I am the bread. So Jesus, when he said these things, these are words that he has spoken, and these are recorded for us through the Word of God. But think about that. If Jesus is the way, if Jesus is the truth, if Jesus is the life that we are all called to live, then what does that really mean for us? And so I really do believe the words of Jesus do matter when it comes to our well-being, when it comes to our future, and all the hope that we can have for our lives. But what about the words of you? What words do you speak over your own life? What words do you speak out of over your friends and family? Or maybe what words do you just speak out when it comes to just everyday life? What words do you speak over yourself are important? And I believe the words that you say to yourself actually can really help you or can really hurt you. So we're beginning to realize that words do matter. And so what words that you hold on to that really mean something to you? What words that have been spoken over your life that actually carry weight with you? I believe there's some words that we have picked up on this journey called life that we need to learn to let go of. I know there's definitely words in my life that I have heard, and thankfully there's not too many words from school or from my younger days, maybe negative words or bad words. I tend to have an ability to forget pretty quickly. My wife thinks it's quite convenient that I forget quite easily, but the truth is negative words, I just refuse to let them hold me or slow me down. And so it's hard to think about negative words. I've definitely experienced them. I'm sure many of you listening today have had negative words, but we've got to make a choice as we move forward. Are we going to let go of some words that are just crippling us? Or are we going to pick up the right words that are going to speed us up? They're going to really make better days for us. And so I really think today's message, Do Words Matter, can really help us to paint a really clear picture about what words can do and what words can do to help us move forward. So that's really the prayer today. That's really the desire today. You know, just recently, there was an inauguration, the 46th President of the United States. And there was a moment that I think captured by so many people that really stood out to so many people. And that's when Amanda Gorman, they stood up and she literally, a wordsmith through poetry, she collectively brought words together in a profound, incredible way. And it was a glimpse, again, the power of words to unite and to build and to bring hope and healing. It was words that she had put together through the uniqueness and the gift that's on her life. And she had a moment in history, a moment in time where we were all suffering from words of hostility and negativity. And she took that platform and she took that moment and she profoundly used words to lift us and to bring a perspective that actually can help us all. And so that was just a glimpse. And I believe there's many times in history where words have been profound in shifting societies. Words have been profound in moving us towards better days. And there's been times in history where we've seen the devastation of words. Words that have divided and separated have brought a lot of harm and a lot of pain. And I really do believe that if we will just allow ourselves today to look at God's word and to gain wisdom from his word when it comes to this particular area, whether we're young in faith or whether we're being seasoned in faith, I really do believe it's good for all of us to remind ourselves about the power of our words and about really the power of what God says over our lives. That's what really makes the difference. So today, I want to just give you some thoughts from the word, and I'm going to go through them. There's many, many words and many, many thoughts I could bring today, but I've just put them down to a few of them today. So the first one I want to share with you is found in Genesis chapter 11, and that is words can unite us and words can divide us. Genesis chapter 11 is interesting because this is what it says. There was a time when the whole world spoke one language. Everyone used the same words. Then people began to move from the east. They found a plain in the land of Babylonia and they stayed there to live. Then they began to say to each other, let's make some bricks of clay and bake them in the fire. And they used these bricks and stones and they used tar as mortar. See, here recorded in Genesis 11 is what we would call the Tower of Babel. That's what it's mentioned as. It's where humanity started working together collectively. There was one language, and there was a common purpose, and they started to build something. And the Bible says they used bricks. They started to make man-made bricks. And it's very interesting because God has always intended man to build with stone, not with bricks. And the reason is because bricks are man-made. They're uniform. They're carbon copies of each other. And yet stone is unique, and not one stone is actually the same unless we chisel it to be the same. But the point is, God is showing that he wants to build with stones. And in the New Testament, we are likened, our lives are likened unto stones that he is building into this spiritual house called the house of God. So I want you to see here that right there in the beginning, where there was a common language, where people shared the same words, they were able to build something, but they weren't building something for God. They were building something for themselves. And instead of using stones, they started to use bricks. And I really want you to notice this, because the word in the Bible here in the Old Testament is very, very interesting, because I think God is wanting us to realize that his intention is for us, our uniqueness. God builds with uniqueness. Every one of us are unique. He doesn't want us to be carbon copies. And that's the metaphor here with bricks and stones. But what's interesting here is that there was a common language and there was common words, and they were able to achieve something. But the point I want to make today is that the words can unite us and words can divide us. And we see that in Genesis chapter 11. Well, here's another one for you. Words actually have consequences. Proverbs chapter 18, verses 20 to 21. I think it highlights the consequences of words. And this is what it says. You will have to live with the consequences of everything you say. What you can say can preserve life or destroy it. So you must accept the consequences of your words. Oh man, that is pretty heavy duty right there. Because I think all of us use lots of words. All of us have spoken many words over the period of time. I'm 52, so I've probably had a lot of chance to speak a lot of words. Recently, someone asked me, they said, you know, what's your strength? What's your strengths? And I don't know if I've got many strengths, but one thing that I said to this person when they asked me about my strengths, they says, I'm good at talking. Some of you are probably nodding your head right now. And the point is I'm Irish. I've got the gift of the gab. God somehow has blessed me with the ability to talk. Again, the Bible just reminds us, again, there's consequences. And I think we have to think about the consequences of the words that we speak. And, you know, do we speak life? Do we speak hope? Do we speak encouragement? I think that is something that we would all say yes to. We would see the importance of it. We should remind ourselves, and we should take ourselves, really, again, seriously about what do we say? How do we say it? Why are we saying it? And what are we trying to achieve with them words? I think that is something we can all be conscious of. Here's another one for you. Words spoken with care have rewards. Proverbs 18, verse 20 to 21. Again, this is the expanded Bible translation. I love this. This is what it says. People will be rewarded for what they say. They will be rewarded by how they speak. What you say can mean life or death. Those who speak with care will be rewarded. I think this is a great translation that just highlights the importance of speaking carefully, you know, being careful about the words that we say. I think today it just highlights really the damage that can be done when we're not careful about the words we use. And here again, it just reminds us that there is a benefit to you, to me, to us, to what we're a part of. So I think we should be careful about the words we use. Think carefully how you say things. I think it's something that I've taken on board seriously as I've grown in my walk with God, as I've become more and more entrusted with greater responsibilities. I've had to really consider how I speak and why I speak and what I'm actually trying to say. You know, there is a lot of benefits and there is a reward for speaking carefully. And I really think it can cause a lot of blessing. It can help people to be at ease and it can reassure people. But when we're not careful with our words, it can really settle, it can mess things up, and it can really cause a spirit of confusion. It can really cause chaos. So I think this is just a great reminder. There is a reward by thinking carefully about the words that we use. And I think that's a great reminder. Here's another one for you. Words need to be consistent. Words need to be consistent. James chapter 3, verses 9 to 11. This is considered the book of James, which is a book of wisdom in the New Testament, full of great practical wisdom. Well, this is what it says. We use our tongues to praise our Lord and our Father, but then we curse people who are created in God's likeness. These praises and curses come from the same mouth. My brothers and sisters, this should not be. I love the way it says there, brothers and sisters, this should not be. I think James is highlighting so strongly here that, you know, we cannot praise God one moment and then curse each other the next. Now, yes, we have the capacity to do that. We do have the ability to praise God and then speak negatively, maybe towards ourselves or towards others. But what James is highlighting is that there needs to be a consistency in our words. And when we're good with Jesus, it's amazing how his influence on our lives, his words over our lives, can help us to become more thoughtful about the words that we speak towards others and towards ourselves. So I really want to encourage everyone today to really ask yourself the question, are my words consistent? Think about it this way. If people were being fed by my words, would they be starving or would they be nourished? I think it's good to ask that question sometimes, because I think when our words are consistent, it can build trust. It can build an atmosphere of faith. And I really believe that we are called to be people that can be trustworthy with our words. So let's ask ourselves a question. Are we consistent in our words? Because it really does bring strength and it brings blessing. So that's another thought. Here's another one for you. Words can bring health to our bodies. How good is that? Proverbs chapter 16, verse 24. Gracious words are like a honeycomb, sweetness to the soul and health to the body. Well, there's no doubt that you and I can speak healing words, words that are full of healing and bring healing to people's lives. I've seen it personally when people have just chosen to speak forgiveness and speak kindness towards another person, how much healing it's brought. I know that you and I have been given the ability. I think just because we're created in the image of God, we have the capacity and the ability to speak healing words to each other. You know, take responsibility for your words and ask yourself, are my words healing? Are they reassuring? Do they bring healing or do they bring pain? I think these are good questions to ask, because we do live in an interesting time where somehow people seem to be firing off words and opinions and statements left, right, and center, and not realize the devastation and the pain and the destructiveness it can bring. So I think it's a good reminder here that actually godly words, wise words, careful words can bring healing. And I really do believe for anyone listening today, if you've ever had any pain caused in your life because of destructive words, painful words, I'm really believing today as we listen to this, as we open up to God's word, that the Holy Spirit can bring healing where there's pain of words in the past. I do believe it is an opportunity for all of us to really make decisions. What words are we going to hold on to? And what words are we going to let go of? What words that have been spoken over us that have brought pain and a lot of discomfort? Well, I believe God wants to reverse that. I really believe his words over your life can bring healing where there's been pain. And I really believe it's something that we can be encouraged by today. Let there be health in your body by the words that you hear. And let the words of God be spoken over you, because that can bring healing. And I believe we can actually speak healing words over our lives as well. So that's something we can consider. Here's another one for you. God's words can bring miracles. God's words can bring miracles. In the Message translation, I love this. In Psalm 119, it says this, every word you give me is a miracle word. How could I not obey? Break open your words, let the light shine out. I love that. Every word is a miracle word. And I believe that's exactly what God can do with his words. It can bring life where there's death. It can bring hope where there's hopelessness. God's word is so powerful that literally it created a planet that was without form or shape, the Bible says in Genesis. And through the Holy Spirit, creatively began to take shape because of the words that God spoke. Let there be light, and there was light. So let's never forget that the words that God speaks over us can create miracles. What is it that you need in your life where God's word can turn it around? Maybe there's people and they're believing to have children, And I believe that, you know, there is practical things we can do, but I believe that there are times where we just got to trust God. And what is it that you need to trust God with, where there's a miracle needed? What is it in a family situation? What is it in a relationship situation? What is it when it comes to work or business? Maybe something shut down on you, or maybe a door is closed, and maybe something you were hoping for has just not materialized. Well, let's be encouraged today with the words that come from heaven, the words that come from our Heavenly Father, because I believe, like it says there in Psalm 119, literally His words can be like miracle words. Amen. Anybody believing for some miracle words over their lives? I really believe that God does speak words and miracle words into us and over our lives, because I believe that's the God we serve. I hope you're encouraged with that today, because I really believe anyone's listening today, if you've hit a dead end, if you've hit something that's just really come to, it's really not gone anywhere, why don't you begin to believe God for breakthroughs on the other side, amen? Because I believe He can, and I believe He will, in Jesus' name. And here, there's another one I want to share with you. Words from Jesus are eternal. You know, when it comes to this whole idea of words, do words matter? I love what it says in Matthew 24, verses 35. Heaven and earth will pass away, but my words will not pass away. In other words, Jesus said, my words are eternal. A lot of things can come and go. A lot of companies have come and gone. Apple's been around for a few years, but who knows in another 100 years if Apple's going to be around. You know, we've got to remind ourselves in this present moment we live about eternal things. We are not here just for a temporary moment. The Bible says that, yes, our life on earth is temporary, but our eternal life is eternal. God didn't call us to live a temporary life. He called us to live eternal life, to be with Him ultimately. And I believe that this reminder that Jesus said, He said literally, my words are eternal. What words are you building your life on? What words are you holding on to? What words that you're going to let define your life? You know, there are things right now that maybe are not helpful. There are things that are maybe are temporary, maybe things that are, you know, being spoken over you and you feel like, okay, that's stopping me from moving forward. I believe there are limitations comes from words, but I pray today, honestly, that you and I will not be speaking limiting words over our lives. I think when we look at these verses that we've looked at today, and there's many, many more, I really want you to understand that God does not limit us. And we should not limit ourselves. And the words that we use should not be limiting our lives. They should be enabling us to build a better life, a better future. So consider today the power of words. What words are you listening to? Who are you listening to? What words that you're listening from other people that you're empowering that you actually need to stop? There are some words that you've got to say no to, and there are some words that you've got to say yes to. So be encouraged today. Get a hold of the words from heaven that are going to sustain you. The words of heaven will nourish us and keep us and bring healing to our bones and body and soul. I believe God's words, they're eternal words, they're hopeful words, they're words that you can build your life on, build your marriage on, build your business on. I believe the words that God speaks over us are the words that really benefit us the most. So let's be people who speak life. Let's be people who realize the power of our words. And let's be people that take responsibility for our words. Let's not be frivolous or careless with our words, but kind of build the kind of community. Let's build the kind of church. Let's build the kind of city that we live in where we're not just careless with our words, but we're purposeful with our words. So my prayer for all of you today that we will just be refreshed in our understanding and our outlook about the words we speak. No matter what your age is, whether you're younger and you're just getting started in life, or whether you're more seasoned and you've had a whole lot of chance for words to limit you or a whole lot of chance for words to build you, let's understand today that words do matter. But ultimately, it's His words that should be defining our lives. Let His word over you be the word, the last word, and the most important word in Jesus' name. Holy Spirit, for whoever's listening today, Lord, remind us all again that Your words are the words that we hold on to. Your words are the words that we are going to feed on, and it's Your words over our lives that are ultimately going to build our lives. God, bring restoration where there's been pain and there's been hurt from previous words of the past. All of us have grown up in an environment where sometimes negative words have played too much importance in our lives. Let today be a day of freedom from negative words. Lord, whatever's been done in the past, Father, we just look to the future as we open our hearts to you, as we open our hearts to the Holy Spirit, as we say yes to your words, and as we take responsibility for the words that we speak over each other and over our own lives. Let there be words that bring healing, and let there be words that bring hope and purpose. In Jesus' name, amen, amen. Well, I hope that's been helpful today. You can get the notes, download them. There's a whole lot more verses that I had for you today, but because of the time, I just wanted to give you them today. So be encouraged, and let's keep moving forward, and let's keep speaking great, great words in Jesus' name. Amen. Swing wide on your heavens. Let the praise go up as the walls come down. Oh, creation, everything with breath, repeat the sound. All your children, clean hands, your hearts, good, great, it's good God. His name is today. I've been talking about the power of our words, and I believe when we use words in a constructive way, in a positive way, it literally can build a better life, a better future for all of us. Well, this moment right now is also about considering what Jesus has done for us on the cross. I believe the words of salvation, or the prayer of salvation, which is an expression of words that comes from our heart, it can literally change our whole outlook on life, the way we see ourselves and the way we see God. And so I want to invite all of you that's listening, all of you that are joining us today, if you've never made a decision to make your peace with Jesus, I would love to invite you to consider that right now. You know, as we pray this prayer of salvation together, the words will come up on the screen. Let these words literally mean something to you in a very powerful way. I believe these words can literally, like I've said, change the whole outlook, and it can change the whole direction of your life. I know when I prayed this prayer, salvation prayer, many years ago, it literally has changed and defined my life in so many ways. So when we pray this prayer, I really believe you're going to sense the Holy Spirit, and I really believe you're going to see better days, my friend. So why don't you take this moment and let's pray this prayer of salvation together. The words are on the screen, and why don't you follow along with me? Jesus, thank you for accepting and loving me. Thank you for dying on the cross, and thank you that you rose again to give me eternal life. Today, I have decided to follow you, Jesus, and accept you as my Lord and Savior. Thank you for forgiving me of all my sins, past, present, and future. From now on, I declare I am loved by God, I am forgiven, and I am a child of God. In Jesus' name, amen. Amen. Well, they are very powerful words, my friend, and we're cheering you on for everyone that's prayed that prayer today. And really want to encourage you to keep moving forward and to get yourself in an environment literally where you're surrounded by godly words, powerful words, words of faith and hope and promise towards you, because it's going to make a massive difference. Be encouraged today. God bless.
Amen, amen. Hey, so cool you made your decision. And you hear that? A big party in heaven just for you. Hey, we are so happy for you, and we cheer you on, either if you made your decision to follow Jesus for the first time or as a recommitment. And we want to help you along this journey, and we can do this best if you let us know who you are, which you can easily do by clicking I have decided in the link below. We would love to hear from you and get to know you.
Awesome. Yeah. So today has been great, but it doesn't have to be over yet. You can still keep on connecting in the online hangouts that are happening right after this service, or you just go out with your buddy for a nice walk, a good coffee, or döner. Yeah. So if you still want to find a buddy, just DM us on Instagram at Hillsong Berlin, and we would love to get you connected.
Döner. No, honestly, let's remember next week, Zoom Sunday, starting all together.
Yeah, great. So have a great week and see you on Tuesday for Enlarge Learning. And yeah, we love you. Bye.
We love you. Bye.
This rhythm.